Question 6. Before solving this question, if you have not yet watched strategies on how to solve a TS question, please do watch that video first. So let us solve this question. This is again a regular data sufficiency type of question, and we are asked to find out the number of households who are having at least one cat or at least one dog, but not both. So we have to find out the households having at least one cat or one dog, but not both. Okay, so this is what we need to find out. Now what do I know? So I know that there are 50 households. Okay, that is what they have given. They have given of a group of 50 households. Okay, they have already provided this data in the question statement. So this is from the question statement always. Okay, question statement. So I know this. Now I have drawn a chart over here. So let us take this as cat, this one as dog, and this is the total number of households. Okay, so let me denote the number of households having at least one cat as X, at least one cat only as X, at least one dog only as Y, and at least one cat and a dog as Z, because this is the intersection of both of them, and the households who are not having any cats or dogs as W. So I simply want to find out the value of households having at least one cat or one dog, but not both. So I need to figure out the value of X plus Y is equals to question mark. Okay, now what do I know from this? I also know that X plus Y plus Z plus W is equals to 50. This is what I know. So now if I am able to figure out the value of X or Y individually, then I can calculate X plus Y directly. So what else do I need to know? I can answer directly X plus Y. Or if else I get to know the value of Z and W, then also I can figure out the value of X plus Y. X plus Y is the number of households having at least one cat or one dog, but not both. Okay, both is this part, Z part. Okay, so let us jump to statement one. What does statement one say? Statement one states that the number of households that have at least one cat and at least one dog is 4. So at least one cat and at least one dog is Z. Z is equals to 4. That is what they have given. So from this, X plus Y plus 4 plus W is equals to 50. But we still don't know the value of W, so we cannot figure out the value of X plus Y. What does the second statement say? So the second statement says that the number of households that have no cats and no dogs is 14. So W they have given as 14. So from this information also, X plus Y plus Z plus 14 is equals to 50. Okay, so we don't know Z over here from this statement. So one thing I forgot, when we get statement one as not sufficient, then we need to cross A and B. That is our first step that we should never forget during the examination. Okay, now we got statement two also as not sufficient. So B option will also get cancelled out. Now let us jump to option number C. Means now let us check which option C and option E. So for that we need to club statement one and statement two. So what does that say? That the number of households having at least one cat and at least one dog is 4, and the number of households having no cats and no dogs is 14. So in short, Z is equals to 4, W is equals to 14. So from this information, X plus Y plus 14 plus 4 is equals to 50. So we are able to figure out the value of X plus Y, which is equals to 50 minus 18, which is equals to 32. So X plus Y, in examination, we need to stop our calculation from this point. We don't need to figure out the value of X and Y, because it is a data sufficiency question. It is not a problem solving question. Means we are able to identify that the two statements together are able to answer our question. So we won't go further. Okay, we won't go into solving the question. So let us cross option number E, and our correct answer will be option number E. I hope it is clear.